Unfortunately, what we are observing is that while cigarette smoking is going down, there is still relatively high rates of the use of other tobacco products, like smokeless tobacco. And the prevalence rates of these other products is actually quite high. So while prevention efforts have been beneficial on smoking cigarettes, we need to emphasize the importance of also targeting these other tobacco products. We're also observing some of the lowest rates of alcohol drinking behavior among all of the grades, 8, 10, 12 grade. And since 1996, when you have the highest rates of alcohol drinking, we've actually seen close to a 50% decrease in daily consumption rates of alcohol. And we're seeing actually what appears to be a 30% decrease in binge drinking behavior, which is very problematic because it's the one that's frequently associated with the most adverse consequences. What we have seen over the past 5 years are increases in the use of marijuana, which have become significant in the 10th and 12th graders. And particularly problematic for this year is the indicator of daily marijuana use that is at its highest that it's been since 1981. And the current daily use of marijuana for 12th graders is 6.2% daily use of marijuana. We're also seeing a decrease in the number of kids that perceive marijuana as harmful. And this is important because throughout the survey, we can predict the rate of utilization of marijuana on the basis of kids perceiving the dangers of this drug. So the fact that we're seeing increasingly greater number of kids not considering it as problematic predicts that either we do an intervention or the use of marijuana is going to continue going up. And to our surprise, the question, which was specifically targeted to 12th graders, was they reported 11% of them had consumed spice in the past year. That's 1 out of 9, which is also very high and unexpected because it's a new drug. So their willingness to experiment for a drug for which there's not much experience at such a high level, again, connotes the urgency to address this so that we can prevent further escalation. Overall, we are observing a very high rate of the abuse of psychotherapeutics. Take, for example, Vicodin, which is a pain medication. We had numbers that went as high as 10.5% of 12th graders in the past year having abused Vicodin, to the current numbers that are approximately 8%. Yeah, and today we're releasing the updated version of our site for providing information on prescription medications to teenagers, PureX, and we're encouraging parents, educators, and physicians to speak about it with the teenagers and encourage them to look and get the information about what we know on prescription medications. Monitoring the future is an extremely valuable public health tool because it gives us important indicators of the pattern of drug use across the country. And without that knowledge, we really do not know how to intervene in terms of prevention efforts. And the prevention efforts for substance, for the diversion of substances or the abuse of substances require strategies that will make, on the one hand, those drugs much less available, but on the other one, education interventions that made kids aware of the adverse effects of these drugs.